More reasons, we are not talent, reggaeton directo, la promo. And today, we have a super special guest, a super female, a female that beat up the assassini, yeah, that is right. And her name is the one, the only, Celeste Bonin, yeah, meow. So people have fun watching assassini get his ass whooped, meow.
This is our assassini, Mr. Real Nonstop Talent, reggaeton directo y la promo. And yes, I'm switching it up. No estamos hablando español today because I don't want to get hit by this beautiful lady that's right next to me.
I threatened them.
Yeah, she already told me I'm going to get punched twice. And those arms are powerful. They're like guns. Wonder Woman's scared of her. Gaga doesn't want to fight with you no more. So people in the past, they knew her as Kaylin.
Right.
But no. She's working with the name that her parents gave her, which is none other than Celeste Bonin.
Kaylin is dead.
Kaylin dead.
We buried her. We had a funeral for her, a Viking funeral. Put her on a boat and set it on fire and sent it out. We didn't really do that, but Kaylin is gone. No more two-tone stripper hair.
Yeah, just one tone.
It's Celeste. It's like kind of like Cher, like the one name. That's what I'm working on making that happen. Yeah.
Okay, so Celeste, what motivated you to become a wrestler? Was this something that was part of your household? Or was this something that you saw with a friend? You're like, I want to do that.
I didn't really grow up watching wrestling, a little bit with my brother, but I was never like a huge fan. And then I just, the opportunity kind of presented itself when I was old. I mean, when I got a little older, when I was an adult. I'm still not an adult.
You're
I'm 31.
Young.
I'm not
She's
really an adult
young.
Yet.
I'm 32, so we're both in the same line.
So I just had this amazing opportunity to get involved. And I guess, you know, all the stars aligned. And I was able to have the opportunity to... I actually debuted on WWE TV, live TV, wrestling for the first time ever. Wrestled my first match on live TV.
Before the name of Kaylin?
No, that was, they gave me the name Kaylin the day that I debuted
on
WWE TV, on NXT, when NXT was still a reality-based elimination show.
Yeah, true. Before they changed the whole
concept.
I was
the original queen of NXT.
Oh, you still are. You know,
I am, yeah.
They think about you all the time. So let's... you had left wrestling for quite a while. What mm-hmm. motivated you to come back? Was there something like you were like, there's something I'm missing to do. I have to come back.
There was, and I didn't really realize it. You know, you don't, sometimes you just don't realize, you know, there's something missing and you don't know what it is until you find it. So I wrestled, I retired from professional wrestling 4.5 years ago, and I didn't step in a ring for 4 years. And then I went through this really tough divorce and all this crazy stuff in my life. And I was starting a YouTube channel.
Really?
And I brought my photographer, and I contacted the only person I knew, where I live in South Florida, close to Fort Lauderdale. So I contacted Pablo Marquez at Main Event Training Center.
Wow.
And I said, hey, Pablo, can I get in your ring and shoot some video footage? Because I'm launching a YouTube channel.
So you weren't gonna jump in the ring
and
nothing.
No, but he said, hell yeah. And he brought in some of his students, and we rolled around for like 3 hours, got some really good footage. And then I left a pair of shoes there. I left a pair of my favorite Chuck Taylors at
You
his
had
school.
To come back.
And he texts me. I love telling the story. And he's like, hey, you left a pair of your shoes here, but I know you'll be back. And so we're like, haha,
like,
LOL.
Dare you?
And then, like, literally 3 weeks later, I was back in the ring just training because I missed it. And it kind of was this, like, this passion that I was kind of reignited when I had got back in the ring the first time. So that's kind of how it all started, and that was like 6 months ago.
That's so crazy. 6 months ago, and she's already in Puerto Rico. Not only is she in Puerto Rico, but in 2 days she's going to come back to Puerto Rico to destroy us with the Hurricane Barrel.
So on the way right now, guys, don't hate me, but Hurricane Barrel is on its way for Puerto Rico, and Barrel is my middle name.
It's her fault. This is
not a work. This is real. Barrel is my middle name. So sorry in advance.
Maria, bro, we are so in trouble. So by any chance of the world, are companies, pretty big companies like ROH or Impact Wrestling or Lucha Libre Underground, are they like in your immediate future, or you just want to stay like indies and work in Puerto Rico and stuff like that?
I've kind of just been, my intention was to never, go back to wrestling and start getting booked and working for all these different companies. That was never my intention. I have a business and I have a life. So I've been kind of just squeezing in wrestling here and there whenever I can. But I don't really know. There's some stuff, a couple little projects I have been working on, keeping under wraps. But I don't know if there's like a full-time wrestling come back in my future, but who knows? I'm here in Puerto Rico to wrestle tonight, and we'll see what happens after this, after Hurricane Beryl hits Puerto Rico.
After she destroys it, she'll probably come back, and today she's going to destroy Roxy and Vanilla Vargas, if I am not incorrect.
That is correct.
The match changed out of nowhere for somebody who got hurt, so they became a triple threat. It was used to be a single match, so
that's
part of. So Celeste, before you were hitting the rings, you were already competing. You were working in bodybuilding. Mm-hmm. So my question goes off of that. When you started your bodybuilding career, were you ever bullied? Because a lot of people see that as a world that's only for men, or if you do this, then you're not feminine enough. Mm-hmm. Did you ever have that problem?
No, I think I really excel in male-dominated industries.
Oh, yeah.
I'm kind of this, like, alpha woman, and I almost take things like that as a challenge.
Awesome.
Right?
That's the way it goes.
So I think I want to get into stuff like that because I see it as a challenge, and the fitness and bodybuilding world and the wrestling world are very similar in a lot of ways, that they're male dominated, but that's a lot of things are changing, especially in the past couple of years for women's wrestling and
definitely
women in fitness. And so it's like our time right now. So girl power.
That's true. She can go to the Impact and destroy the Knockouts. She can go and destroy the Divas. She can destroy her. Who the hell is going to stop her? So any last thing you want to tell all the fans that are watching us through Reggaeton Directo en la Promo?
I think the only thing that we didn't really cover is, so just so you guys know me as Caitlin. Caitlin is no
dead.
More. Yes,
she went to Nephilim.
And it's Celeste, and big things in the future as Celeste, and Hurricane Beryl apparently
will destroy us. That's the next big thing.
Yeah, so keep an eye out, and I'll be here rocking flannel for the rest of my life.
Yeah. One last thing, of the future projects, is there any clue you can give us?
No, I feel like that would just give it away.
Oh,
you're spoiling things for people.
Yeah, but I'm
not here. I'm gonna. Oh! I told him it was coming.
Wait! Oh, guys, you hit hard. I thought you were joking.
No, I like warmed up and everything inside before we did this.
Oh yeah, well, we'll find out later on what is she working on. This is Arzacini.
Woo! It'll be okay.
Mr. Rio Nonstop Talent, take it away.
I'm Celeste, and this is the story of my personal renaissance. I started my career in the WWE in 2010. I was just a baby. And I kind of just threw myself into the business without having any experience or knowledge or any idea of what I was getting into. Throughout my career, I learned a lot about myself, and I learned that I was able to adapt to certain situations. I was able to be strong physically, mentally, and emotionally, and take a beating and learn how to get up and do it all over again the next day. And I learned how to be passionate about something that I truly loved. So fast forward 4 years later, I decided that I had made my mark and I had accomplished everything that I wanted to accomplish during that time, and I retired from the WWE, and I started a business, and I started a new relationship. My life completely changed. I went from wrestling in front of thousands and thousands of people and, millions of people on TV, and basically went from that to sitting at home all day trying to figure out how to launch a business and how to be a partner in a serious relationship. And over the course of time, I had certain triumphs, whether it was being on the cover of a magazine or growing my business faster than I thought. I sort of, along the way, lost a part of myself, and it just continued into like a downward spiral. My relationship was toxic. I went through depression, and I went through addiction, and I went through a period of time where I was kind of lost. I would wake up and I didn't really have a purpose. I was just kind of in slow motion. I was stuck in one spot and I didn't know how to get out of it. And I lost my passion and I lost my vision and I didn't know how to get it back. So throughout all of these dark times, I realized that I needed to make a change. And so in the beginning of 2017, I completely changed every aspect of my life.
I wasn't ready. I was terrified. I knew how hard the road ahead of me was going to be, but I didn't care because I wasn't happy and I didn't feel like I was fulfilling my destiny. So moving to this year, I ended relationships. I completely changed my life. I, you know, changed all aspects of my business, you know, from how it runs to employees and my business plan, and discovering what it is that I want to do and what message that I want to spread and what message I want to put out. When you're putting on a match or you're in the middle of a promo or whatever it is, you're asking people to be emotionally invested in you as a character and in your story, which is a lot to ask. So I took that and I sat down and I said, wow, that's like a very pivotal thing that I took away from this career that I had. And now I need to learn how to apply it to my business and all of the things that I want to do in my current life, and to use my voice to spread empowerment and, you know, believing in yourself and having confidence and understanding that those dark times that you go through are absolutely necessary to make you the best version of yourself, and you're constantly evolving.